Where is the hope for our children in trying to get them an education that makes them marketable within the new economy of the 21st century?
I think we have a very serious challenge ahead of us. Nobody is happy with this graduation rate. Every time we lose a child who drops out of school, we put that child in harm's way, could end up becoming part of our correctional institutions, you know, those upstate prisons.
Let me just interrupt for a quick second, because we hear all of these platitudes coming out of the Department of Education and the mayor's office about how successful and how we're moving forward in the context of education. People in East Harlem don't feel the same way.
I don't think it's limited to just East Harlem. I think it is a citywide problem. First of all, I do support mayoral control. I think in the long run, having one person in charge of the school system with a chancellor gives voters, parents, the opportunity to critique one individual. Before the system, I mean, you couldn't hold anyone accountable. So there has been some accountability. Where the DOE is making mistakes and where I've criticized them is they have too many bureaucrats with too many big contracts and not enough educators in the streets actually doing the work. We also have shunned parents and kept them out of the planning process and the education process. And every study shows that when parents are involved in a school, reading and math scores go up.
Now, what does that say to these kids in East Harlem who may be 12 years old, should be in the 7th grade or in the 5th grade, reading at 4th grade level? I mean, how do we reconcile those issues to give these kids some hope?
I think that every time we're able to fund an after-school program, every time we're able to fund a daycare center, every time we have kids, whether it's GED or staying in the classroom, we save a child, and then we save the village. In Albany, there was, for the last 10 or 15 years, elected officials in upstate New York thought it was better to build a prison as not a way to reduce crime, but to create economic development in that community. Mm-hmm. And everybody knew it. They were heroes. 18 months, you can get a prison into a community. You're reelected. You're the man, because it's mostly men. We have a different priority in New York City. We don't want to build prisons. We want to build after-school programs. We want to build schools. We want to build programs or create programs that will take a child off the streets and into something productive. But the problem is that it takes 18, 20 years to know if that program succeeds. And politicians...
We can't wait.
Politicians need that re-election quick fix, so it's easy after 18 months to get a prison. We've got to fight that, and I think the fact that we are now downsizing the prisons because they turned out not to be needed, they were a waste of money, and they were built for the wrong reasons in most cases. Now we have the opportunity to realize what our real priorities are, so we can get that 12-year-old before that kid is 16, 17, 18, and gets in trouble.
Let me draw out two examples. You've been an advocate for community schools, and I believe an advocate for charter schools. And internally, there's a whole fight relative to how many community schools are funded. And we had this whole fight about, you know, raising the cap on how many charter mm-hmm. schools we can have. Now, what's in the best interest of the people of East Harlem in terms of community schools as opposed to charter schools?
Well, I'll tell you what's not in the best interest of the people in this community. This silly struggle that's going on in Albany, where we've almost jeopardized and the jury's still out, losing $700 million in Race to the Top funding. I think the way this played out, if I was the federal government or the Secretary of Education, I would look at what happened in the state legislature and say, what are you doing? And I hold the Department of Education accountable to this as well.
Well,
this
I believe they raised the cap.
Well, they finally raised the cap, but we'll see if that gets us the money that we need to help education. $700 million is hanging in the balance. And if the mayor and the chancellor are going to make this school system work, there has to be respect for the public schools that exist in communities, and there has to be an ability for people to come in and solve these co-location problems, solve these problems that we have people who are in these schools butting heads, but not, and we're losing the ability to educate children because the adults are fighting too much.
Well, that's what it sounds like,
that
while we're fighting over the political means of one party or the other, our kids remained uneducated.
Well, I will tell you something.
And you know where that leads.
Yes, it leads up to upstate New York, and it leads to those prisons that are now empty, waiting for the next generation of kids if we're not careful. And you and I grew up in a neighborhood where people came from different backgrounds, but our kids in this city who go to public school are very sophisticated. They know when they're being disrespected. They know when those overcrowded classrooms are about them or the lack of textbooks. And that's when kids feel that the adults have given up on them and that they have to take matters into their own hands. And when you're a teenager thinking that you're not being respected, you're not giving every opportunity to learn, that's when you go to the streets and that's when the trouble starts. And that is something that we have to be very focused on, because it's not just about somebody dropping out of school, you really are dropping out of society.
So what hope are we offering them right now?
I'm offering the ability for us to have a full-on organizational opportunity for parents to come together, community advocates to come together, to participate in elections, to hold elected officials accountable, get people to understand that they have to vote, they have to go to meetings, they have to participate because their children's future is at stake. We have, putting the Obama election aside, the 2009 mayoral election turnout was dismal, dismal. We've got to energize folks. That's why I started Go Green East Harlem, because it was time to bring people together around environmental issues. That's why in July, I'm gonna be out again working with Jose Serrano, Bill Perkins, Inez Dickens, Charlie Rangel. We're having a big town hall meeting. We're gonna talk about affordable housing.